Berks Vibe is underwritten by Kopicki Photography, 300 Cherry Street, Reading, PA, 19602.
I'm Marcia.
And I'm Jack.
And we have a really great show for you tonight.
We always have a good show.
Well, this is true. We always have a great show. Jack's going to tell you about our tape segment in just a moment, but after that, we're going to have some really great live guests. We're going to be talking about the Jimbo Jam, and then we're also going to be talking to the Citadel and Reading High School band directors, and I think you're in for a real treat.
Yeah. Marcia, we ended up on Pricetown Road again. I don't know how we always get up on Pricetown Road, but we were at Gosser's Mini Golf and Driving Range.
It's Gosser's.
It's not Gasser's. And you see the sign, I'm sure, driving by all the time. It's a beautiful facility. Mm-hmm. And we spoke with Wayne Cawley, owner of Gosser's, and we have a great segment.
Yep.
Let's show it. I'm Jack.
And I'm Marcia.
And we're at Gosser's Driving Range and Miniature Golf.
Yes.
With Wayne Cawley. Hi, Wayne.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Wayne's the owner?
He is. And who knows? I always said Gasser's.
So, that's
Gasser's, Gosser's, tomato, tomato, it all works.
It should be Gosser's.
Like Target.
Like Target, exactly. It's Gosser's.
But it's beautiful enough to call Gosser's.
It really is. It's well, this is a great place. I mean, if anybody, we're out Pricetown Road, and it's the best driving range ever, and they have a putting green. And Wayne, tell us a little bit about this. You've been here for 40 years, and give us some background.
We opened in 1970. My father-in-law started it. I've been working here over 30 years, full time.
Did you meet your wife here?
School. Uh-huh. Yeah, we were classmates, and he passed away 11 years ago, and that's when we took over the reins, and we've made a lot of improvements since then, and we're quite proud of it.
We were talking about the beautiful pavilion back there, and I didn't realize it was there the last time I was here, but it's beautiful.
Thank you. Yeah, we put that up in 2001.
Did you cater to events there, or people
birthday
can
birthday parties, groups, church groups, Cub Scouts, and you know, stuff like that.
And they can bring the food here, or you offer it?
Well,
or?
We kind of like them to buy our food.
Sure. Well, okay. I didn't know if you offered that. If you offered your catering,
hot dogs, hamburgers, pizzas, and whatnot. We have some group rates where we put miniature golf and ice cream and a soda and hot dog together, and it works out pretty nice.
I think it sounds great.
Ice cream, Marcia.
I know.
Nice soft ice cream.
I know. No, I like scooped ice cream. But Wayne, tell us, we're standing on the putting green.
It is perfect.
It is very perfect. And then you have the driving range. Tell us a little bit, how far out does the range go? How much is a bucket of balls? Can you rent a driver if you have to?
Yeah, we supply clubs for the driving range. There's no charge for that. We have four different size baskets from $6.50 to $14. Miniature golf is $5. Putting green is $3. So it's, you know, pretty much a little bit of everything.
We didn't even get to the miniature golf yet. This is for like the serious people who like to practice, and there's lots of people practicing out here. I haven't picked up golf clubs in I don't say how long, but it's fun to come out here. Today we are here at a beautiful, perfect day. So.
Yeah, it is.
Well, I think they got the big buckets out there. They look like they're hacking away.
Well, that's the large. There's one bigger than that yet.
Oh my goodness! And how many balls do you get?
The largest is 150.
Oh my gosh!
That is a
that's some serious practice.
That's like three rounds of golf. You don't count in the putting.
So I always wondered this. How far out does the range go? It looks like 250 yards?
300 yards.
Oh, 300 yards, yeah. Okay. Yeah. And then how do you get all the balls?
Well,
do you have a machine, or what do you do?
A machine, yeah.
Okay.
Picks most of them,
mm-hmm. And then do you wash them?
Yep, we wash them, put them back in the bin.
And do you scoop them up every day? I always wanted to know
the behind
the scenes.
Well, I'd like to be able to.
But you can't.
Business, the more often you have to pick them up.
That's true.
Do you end up doing it? Do you end up doing some of those tasks?
Most of those. I have a helper.
Right.
A young man that helps me.
You also have a helper with
teaching people.
Yes, Don Sowers is our teaching professional. He's been here for 25 years now and still doing a great job.
So you can just come up and get lessons?
Well, he doesn't by appointment. He's mm-hmm. here 3 days a week, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Saturday.
Okay.
And yeah, he does a great job. Very nice gentleman.
Very good. Awesome. Well, I think this is great. I think we should go check out the miniature golf.
Maybe, John, maybe I can putt a couple of feet for that.
You want to putt? All right.
Yeah, I'll have
maybe
to do
we'll
that.
Come back and putt. You're not going to embarrass yourself, are you?
No, maybe. But driving maybe.
All right.
Back out on the golf course.
Well, we're back out on the miniature golf course.
On miniature golf.
And it is so pretty, Wayne. You have the best landscaping, the bluest water, the best 19th hole ever. How would you not want to come here to miniature golf? How much is it to miniature golf here?
$5 for adults, and we have a children's rate for kids under 38 inches tall.
Marcia, with everything being $9 and $10 and $12, $5?
I know, that's what I was just thinking. Now, you have kids, so in your mind, it would be $10 for you to bring your kids here to miniature golf.
What a deal.
Or 20, you know, even if you and Lori would come. I mean, that's a deal. And on a day like this, it's a beautiful, beautiful thing.
The three of us went to the movies last week. Almost $30.
That's crazy. And here you're outside having some fun in the sunshine. It's awesome. So I like it very much. Now, Wayne, you have a special 19th hole. Why don't you tell us about that?
Okay. It's fashioned after an outhouse, and it's a two-seater.
There's the outhouse.
We're going to have to try that a little later, Jack.
You're going to put the ball in a hole about 2 inches.
Okay.
And you get a trophy and a free bucket of balls and a round of miniature golf.
How big is that trophy?
About 6 inches.
That's pretty great.
Maybe we can do it.
I love it.
We'll try. How many winners have you had? It would seem like you wouldn't have very many.
We've had 60-some, almost 70 so far this year.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's a lot of winners.
And then we post their name on a sheet on the wall.
So you're on the Hall of Fame
wall
inside.
Of fame.
The Gossers Hall of Fame.
The Gossers Hall of Fame.
We have everyone's name up there since 1981 that ever made the 19th hole here.
Wow.
Have you made it?
Only practicing.
Only practicing. Well, I'll tell you what. This course looks like you just put it in. It is pristine. I am dead serious. It's gorgeous.
Thank you.
It's really
you.
Beautiful.
We do work hard at it.
Clearly you do. It's a great place. And it seems as though, how late are you open? Because I see lights, so somebody can come and golf.
Our normal summer hours are 10 to 10 daily.
Okay. And when do those end?
Sometime in September we'll start cutting back the evening hours.
Okay.
Go 9 and then 8. And then eventually we'll close at dark.
We are impressed by the blue water. It almost looks chlorinated. what's with the blue, pretty blue water?
Well, we do dye it. I put a dye in. It helps with algae control and keeps it nice and clean and pretty.
It's beautiful.
Thank you.
So after you frustrated yourself on the driving range, then you've come and relaxed with your family at miniature golf, then we can go inside because you have a really great snack bar,
ice cream. We have soft serve. It's a soft ice, kind of like a soft serve Italian ice, which is
like
really
a gelato.
Well, it's a non-dairy product.
Okay.
And then we have hand-dipped ice cream, flurries, banana splits, sundaes, whatever you can think of, we'll make for you.
A little for everybody.
Yeah. Yep.
Awesome. And then what kind of food do you have? You're saying hamburgers and
hot dogs
and
pizza, french fries, a normal snack bar fare.
All right.
And it was reasonable. I saw the prices, really great prices, too.
Yeah, thank you.
I think it's an all-around great deal to come here because it's beautifully maintained. It's totally affordable. It's very accessible. You just go right out Route 12, heading toward Pricetown, and it's right next, not far from Spade's Nursery.
Yeah.
I give people a point of reference. But what a great day or afternoon or evening because you just come here and hit some golf balls after work or bring your kids here.
Bring a date. Do you remember that dating, Marcia? Do you remember that? Used to take
Yes. Yes, it's been so long. I have to talk to Brett about that. Maybe we'll come on a date, miniature golfing. We'll double date.
Okay, well, that's a deal.
All right. It sounds good. Well, Wayne, this is wonderful. Is there anything else that we have forgotten to mention about your wonderful establishment here?
We do have a teaching pro here.
Okay.
Don Sowers. Did we mention that?
I think we did, but it's okay if we do again.
He's been with us 25 years. Very good teacher, very nice gentleman.
Is he patient?
Absolutely. The most patient person I have ever known.
As you know, but I think that sounds, somebody might say, oh my gosh, a private teacher for golf. Is it expensive to get private golf lessons?
He charges $40 for adults and $30 for kids in school yet.
Okay.
Including up to college for most.
That's not a bad deal. And that's for an hour lesson?
Half hour.
Okay.
Most of them run an hour, but
sure,
he schedules that for an hour.
That's awesome.
Once he gets through those bucket of balls, does he do a bucket of balls?
He has a big basket. And they go until he's done. Or the next person comes in.
Oh, boy. Well, again, this has been a wonderful experience, and thank you so much for having us. All right.
Thanks, Wayne.
Yep.
Are we going to go to break, Paul, or do you want us to? All right.
You're watching Berks Vibe on bctv.org. Be informed, be involved, be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For other information on local activities and a local activities calendar, go to bctv.org. Berks Vibe on bctv.org is supported by Kopicki Photography. To find out how you and your business can support a program on BCTV, go to bctv.org.
Now we're officially back. No more breaks. No more anything.
I have to clarify something. I didn't make it.
No. Why are you telling people that?
I have to be honest.
Nothing with the memory. You got the hole in the one.
Hi, Margaret. I just want to say hello to you.
You sure looked like you enjoyed that ice cream.
It was excellent.
Anyway, we never went on our date either.
Well, we can do that. Wayne, save us a spot. We'll be up.
We'll be out to miniature golf. So, anyway, without further ado, I'd like to introduce the guests that we have with us this evening. To my immediate right is Liz McCauley, and you're kind of the steam behind the Jimbo Jam,
okay.
And we'll talk about that in a minute. And then we have Brian Simpson, and he's the Reading High School band director. And then we have Charlie DeCarney, who is the Citadel band director, and the Citadel is new this year.
All right, Charlie.
That's awesome. Yeah, you like it. It's big.
I read the comments
in the paper, and all the kids are like, I didn't know it was going to be so big. And
oh, it's wonderful.
Good.
It's wonderful.
Excellent. Very good. Well, the reason we have such an interesting group gathered here is Liz McCauley, she's going to talk about the Jimbo Jam, which is going to benefit the Reading School District's band programs. So let's start with the Jimbo Jam. Tell us about that, how it got started, and how it's going to benefit. And give us the details, too, if somebody wants to attend
sure.
the Jimbo Jam.
Absolutely. Well, thanks, guys, for having me on the show.
I really appreciate it.
Last year, my husband, Jim McCauley, passed away sort of unexpectedly. He was diagnosed with cancer in the spring and passed away in the fall. And he was a local musician. He's been playing music his entire life. He started at a very, very young age, and music was a very important part of his life. And we played music locally in a band and an acoustic act. And when he passed away, you know, I thought I really wanted to do something to turn, you know, what is something obviously very tragic. He died at a young age. I wanted to turn it into something positive.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. And decided, you know, to do something with music. And I reached out to a lot of different groups and organizations. And the guys that came back to me with the most enthusiasm, which was a perfect fit, was these guys from Reading High School. And we decided to start a fund. It's called the Jimbo Jam Memorial Fund. It's going to be administered through the Reading Musical Foundation, which is a fantastic organization.
Yes,
I'm really glad I found
so.
Them, working with Carrie Schultz over there. Mm-hmm. And we're having an event, our first event, hopefully the first of many, on October 16th at the Kenhurst Fire Company. Okay. And it's called the Jimbo Jam. A lot of local musicians are coming out. Just about everyone Jim has ever played with over the years is coming out. My band's going to finish out the night. My acoustic
cool.
act's going to finish out the night. That's actually my husband.
Nice.
And yeah, so it's going to be a great time. And all the funds raised are going to be put into this fund. And we are going to work then directly with Charlie and Brian at Reading School District to do things with that money to help their program. So it can be anything from purchasing instruments for the kids who can't afford them, mm-hmm. which is obviously a very tough situation for many kids in the school district. Mm-hmm. We hopefully can provide some private lessons for them, for kids that are exceptional or that really just need help with the private lessons. And we're hoping to evolve this fund over the next couple of years. We'd like to keep it going. We'd like to do events every year. And we're hoping a lot of people come. I've already sold over 55 tickets, so get your
Great.
Tickets. I have a limited amount, so we've had some sizable donations from some of my husband's clients and some of our good friends, and that's great. And the really great thing is that there's anonymous donors through Reading Musical Foundation right now who are willing to match 50 cents on the dollar. So for every dollar
awesome.
We raise, we get an extra 50 cents, which is fantastic. So we're hoping to raise a lot of money, and it's going to benefit these guys, their program, and I've been very impressed with what they're doing with the program. So,
and we're going to talk to them
yes.
very shortly, but just so people know, it's October 16th.
October 16th.
It starts at what time?
It starts at 6 o'clock, 6 to 10. You can get tickets by rocking Lead Woman at Comcast.net or my phone number, which is 610-796-2126.
Great.
And contact me, and we'll get you tickets.
Always Perfect. Like to know what kind of food we're serving. What
it's
kind of
beef and beer and wine, complimentary wine and beer, beef and all the sides, and everything, all the food's included.
And so how much are the tickets?
$25 for
That's
the tickets.
That's such a deal.
That's great.
It's a great deal.
And you
it's
have bands
deal.
Playing all night.
We do, from 6 to 10. There's going to be acoustic acts. There's going to be bands. Like I said, a lot of musicians that are dusting off their instruments to come out and play. So it's
That's
going to
great.
Be really exciting, and we hope to see a lot of people there.
You're Perfect. Selling so many tickets. How many tickets are you selling?
About 200 is where we're okay. limited to with Kenhurst Fire Company. So
they're going to go quick.
They will, so
Good.
Call me.
Good. But most importantly, it's benefiting Brian and Charlie and their kids at the Reading High School Band and the Citadel Band.
Mm-hmm.
Brian, tell us... clearly you're excited to get this money.
Absolutely.
So why don't you kind of give us a taste? We're going to get into a little bit more of what the band does and how it benefits the kids, but the money that you're going to get, how are you going to use that, and what's it mean to you and the kids?
Well, like Liz said, we're trying to help students out who are already dedicated to the program. They want to be musicians, but they might not have the funds available at home. To go on to college, to go on to a music school for private lessons, to make an audition, mm-hmm. This is probably going to be the primary way that we can help these kids along, and that's really what we're looking for. If a kid just needs a little help buying an instrument, or even if they just need a couple extra bucks every week to go get lessons, that's
get
what
lessons.
This is about.
That's awesome. And Charlie, you're with the Citadel, and I guess that's kind of a new dynamic. You were telling us earlier that the two of you are kind of the band directors for the entire band, but you've
that's
kind
right.
of broken it into the concert, the two different bands. Is that going to be your vision, or are you going to think you might have two bands eventually?
Absolutely. We're going to, the band's growing each year, which is phenomenal. And within a few years or so, we're probably going to have a 9th and 10th grade concert band down to Citadel, and then 11th and 12th grade band at the high school.
That's great, because I mean, so many studies have shown how important music is
Absolutely.
In
math
a child.
Skills,
math skills,
sure.
Kind of the whole work. So, you have a DVD, and I think that might be real informative for people, because I think it's going to give them actually see some students.
Mm-hmm.
It'll kind of set up the rhythm of the night, which mm-hmm. we're going to talk about shortly. So, if we can, let's show that DVD, and you'll get a really good flavor for where the Jimbo Jam money's going. Mm-hmm.
My name's Brian Simpson. I'm the director of the Running High Red Knight Marching Band.
What attracts me about band the most, because there are a few things, is the music. I was a band for a very long time, and my mom told me I had to do marching band, but I kind of love it now. I don't want to quit.
I made tons of friends in bands, so that kept me coming back, and I loved playing the flute, and then I learned to love marching too. It's really fun.
What attracts me to the band would probably be the fact that it's really fun and you get to meet new people. It's a lot of work, but it's all worth it in the end.
I think it's going to be an awesome show this year. I went to the summer leadership camp for the section leaders this year, and just the look on my face when I was telling other kids from other schools about my show, I was so excited, and they were like, wow, like that's awesome, it sounds really cool, and I was just sitting there like, yeah, it is really cool.
Your show is so creative. It took a great mind to make it.
He's not even listening.
And yet again, it's different.
The theme for our show this year is called The Two Paths. And what we're doing is taking the idea of choice, the moment of choice when you've got to decide between two choices, the conflict that goes on within oneself, and we're representing that with the band on the field. We're dressing half the band in black pants, half of the band in white pants, to visually represent the idea of two choices to be made.
All right. Well, we cut it just a little short, but I think everybody got the flavor of it. Mm-hmm. So we really want to talk about the rhythm of the night, which is something that everybody can come to.
That's right.
Everybody can come and support Reading High School Band and the Citadel Band. But then there's also other bands in the county and the surrounding county. So tell us a little bit about that.
Correct. Well, rhythm of the night, it's on October 2nd. And basically what it is through cavalcade of bands. It's a circuit that incorporates local high school bands, as well as bands from central PA, all over eastern PA, and they're all doing field shows just like we are right now, and we get together and we compete against each other in a very, very positive aspect. Everybody basically is a winner. The kids have a great time with it, and it also is a way that we can raise some money for our own program as well, through admission and ticket prices.
Excellent. And it's October 2nd.
October 2nd.
But it's during the day. It's not.
That's right.
It's kind of the rhythm of the day. Not the rhythm of the night.
We changed it a little bit. It starts at 1 p.m. this year.
And it's at
Shirk Stadium.
The Albright Stadium.
Okay. Doors will open the gates around noontime.
Okay. Right. And it's, you were telling me the ticket prices?
$7 for adults and $5 for students.
Okay.
No pre-sale tickets.
There are no pre-sale. Just
tickets at the door.
Show up. There is no cap on tickets, so. You know, we'll take everybody.
Big stadium.
Stuff them all in. And okay. So we have Reading High, and then you have other Berks County bands?
That's correct.
Okay.
For example, we have Governor Mifflin coming. We have Greater Nanticoke, if those of you are unfamiliar with it. That's up above Scranton. So, we've got bands all over the place that are coming to our show.
Awesome. Very good. And then you're also going to be in the Labor Day Parade.
That's correct.
Because this show's live the 1st.
Yep.
So.
This coming Monday, we'll be marching through the streets of Reading.
Excellent.
I'll wave to you.
Are you going?
Yeah, Lori's in the
parade. You're really good like that. Oh, she's in the parade.
She's in the parade.
Oh, that's right. She's in the parade. I should maybe go. We'll see. Yes. I don't know. But I think that tape was kind of indicative of the camaraderie,
the enthusiasm.
Yeah,
a lot of fun.
That the kids have. And you actually have all kind of different programs throughout the year that they go to. They play, you were telling me, at different venues. Because I think, Liz, you wanted to make that point. The kids that are going to get the money from the Jimbo Jam, the ones that it's going to benefit, they're also kids that are going to be giving back to the community
right.
as well.
That's exactly right. We've already talked to these guys about that, and they'll make sure that they go out and do community work, and that's important to give back to.
Absolutely. Well, I'm getting the sign waved at me for goodbye. So our time seems so short, so I want to thank all of you for being with us.
Thank you, guys.
Good luck with everything.
Thank you.
And I'm sure we live near a Shirk. We'll be hearing that. I know we will.
We'll have to look at our schedules.
Yes. Anyway. All right. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Vibe is underwritten by Kopicki Photography, 300 Cherry Street, Reading, PA, 19602.